Good day to all. Today we are going to see about additionals. This is one topic I have been searching for a proper tutorial for a very long time, but I couldn't find anything in YouTube or any other source. Okay, after much R&D activities and trial and error methods, at last I was able to get a grasp of this topic, which I have been using it for a long time, for a while at least. Okay, so which I wanted to share with you all through this video. Additionals. What are additionals? Additionals are nothing but the extra things that come with the main article. For example, your stickers, labels, and other things. Okay, in SAP IS-RETAIL, we have this material type called VKHM, based on which we create the additionals. So these additionals which we create has to be linked to the article master. Okay, so once a link is enabled, then you have to decide how these additionals should be purchased. For example, whether you want the additionals to be ordered with an external vendor when you are pricing a purchase order for this material, or when you are receiving the goods into your stock, okay, or whether you want to do it manually irrespective of these things, and which format you want to do, whether you want to raise a purchase order and send it to the vendor, or you want to generate the additionals iDoc. So this is something you have to decide and configure. I will try to take through these configurations and master data maintenance and see how to generate the additionals purchase orders and additionals iDocs automatically as well as manually through the additionals monitor. Okay, so first let us see what are all the configurations. So to see the configurations, we go to the Logistics General Additionals procedure for additionals. So here you have to define the procedure and say like where this particular thing should be happening. So let us use let me not mess up with the standard. So let me, I have created one additional, so we will make modifications in this procedure itself and see that. So I have created a procedure, and this procedure should be triggering the additionals purchase orders when I create a purchase document, or whenever I am doing the goods movement, or whenever I am creating the deliveries outbound or inbound, or whenever I am creating the sales orders. Okay, so the thing is like at one point of time any one will be the precedence. For example, I have created this procedure and I have assigned the activity for all of these things. Okay, if that is the case, the system will try to see whether you have any procedure or a follow-up action associated with this purchasing activity. If it is there, it will create a, it will carry out the action here itself, and then it will not create further POs when you are creating, doing a goods movement or delivery or sales order, even though you had assigned the events for that. Okay, so first let me start with this. So what it says, whenever I am creating a purchase order or document category of type F, F stands for purchase order. Whenever I am creating a document category F and the order type, okay, class type and class is like whether you want this to be happening for a set of plants. Okay, I have created 030 and WWDC alloc group. Okay, so if I do this, what will happen is the system will If I do this, the system will create additionals only for the sites that belong to this allocation group. If I leave it blank, the system will generate additionals PO for all the purchase orders you are creating. Okay, so I had said when I am creating a purchase order, when I am creating a document with document category F and order type NB, okay, what should be the follow-up action? You generate a purchase order for additionals, and in the second sequence, follow-up action, which should be in the second of the sequence, it should be updated in the retail information system, update as purchase order. Okay. So when I had said this, once you create a purchase order for a material which is having additionals associated with it, once that purchase order is created, when you are running this additionals monitor, it will pick the number of additionals required and it will create an additional PO. It's not updating the same PO, it will create an additional PO to the vendor for the additionals. So that is something called a check vendor or method. If you check it, the system will try to look whether the vendor for which you are creating a PO is having a additionals procedure assigned to that. Only if this procedure is assigned against that vendor, system will generate a PO. Else, it will not generate a PO. Okay, so this is a part of master data. Where this master data can be maintained? Logistics. This is a part of supplementary logistics services. Okay, so merchandise logistics, merchandise distribution, supplementary, additionals, mass maintenance, method and vendor. Okay, so here you should maintain that WW01. This is the vendor which I am going to use for our demo. So this vendor should have this procedure G001. At this moment it is not assigned. Okay, so when you try to create a PO, the system will not generate a PO for additionals automatically. Not automatically, it will not generate. Okay, so if you want the system to check this at the time of, you must have maintained this master data. If you hadn't maintained it, you will not be able to generate the PO for additionals automatically. Okay, so since I have maintained, okay, so let me maintain it. Since I have maintained and I am confident of that, so let me check this, check vendor or method. And once you have done that, you need not configure that. So I tested it. Okay, so I had tested everything by populating all 4, 3, 2 and 1, and I noticed that at one point of time the first available successful follow-up action is getting determined, and that is what triggering the PO. Okay, so let me remove all these stuffs. So this basically says whenever there is a goods movement type, whenever you receive the material against a PO in a MIGO transaction or through inbound delivery creation, it generates a material document and the stock is updated with the movement type 101 or 501. Okay. So whenever there is a goods movement, at the time only the system will generate the PO for additionals. Okay. So let me remove this. I don't have anything maintained here. So at this moment, I have only set only for this PO. So whenever I am creating a PO, and if the vendor meets with the procedure for additionals successfully, that requirement is met, then the system will generate a PO for additionals automatically, not automatically, through the monitor. So this is the most important configuration. So once you have defined the procedure, next three are optional. You can say that this is an optional step. You can restrict that this merchandise category can have only this additional procedures. Similarly, you can say you have the merchandise category for additionals, right? So you are defining the attributes of the merchandise categories of additionals, saying that for this merchandise category additionals, this is the, when you are generating the iDoc for additionals PO, so this should be the logical message type, and at the time of iDoc generation, use this purchase organization. And if you are calculating the additionals, that is the handling cost, what should be the condition type that should be used in your purchasing document? Okay, so this is the standard one. I have created a merchandise category WWADD additionals. So in that I had said, whenever you are creating, use this message type WTTAD, this document type, and this should be the cost center account assignment, and this should be the condition type that have to be used when you are using the additionals costing. So once you had done all these things, now we have to proceed to maintain the master data. So in the master data, like we had seen one, you can say what should be the procedure for additionals and vendors. That is the, you are linking the vendor as well as the additionals procedures. Okay. Similarly, you can maintain the additionals in the articles through mass maintenance. Before that, I will show you in which how to maintain the additionals in the material master. Okay. So slash n mm42. So 100059. Okay. Basic data. Additional data. In the traditional data, you go to the additionals tab. So you are saying what is the sales unit each, and whether you want the sites have a different additional procedures. For example, I am saying for all my sites of, so all the sites that are all the DCs that are grouped together can have this material WW sticker and this pricing procedure, sorry, additional procedure. Okay, I can say, but when the stores are ordering, they should have labels and a different additional procedures if needed. Okay. So we have create, I have already created two additionals, WW stickers. Okay, it was of article, the standard article type is VKHM, but I created my own article type WWAD, that is for additionals. And we have other article WW labels. So this is of type VKHM. So I didn't change the article type. So VKHM as the labels. So now I have assigned these additionals to the article 100059, so that when I am ordering, I should be able to generate a PO for additionals. Okay, So now let me create a sales, purchase order. Let me do 1 yen. Ten pieces to my site W001. So there is a PO created. Let me copy this number. W001 belongs to the DC group, so it should generate an additional for stickers. Okay, so then I go to the additionals monitoring 59. So it says there is a PO for which you have to create corresponding to. So I select that and go to the generate purchase order. Yes, the system has created an additional PO. Okay, so let me see what is there in that slash n me 22n. Four three four is our regular PO, and 435 is what that has been created for additionals. Now you could see there is a additionals PO created. Okay, so this is the basic purchase price for additionals, other things. Okay, so this is one way of how the additionals are generated for the PO. Now let us make change in the procedure. So let me go back to this procedure for additionals G001. I remove that. You can try when you are trying or when you are doing your own research, you can see what happens when you check this, but you don't maintain the relationship with the vendor and the additionals procedure. And second thing, don't maintain the relationship between the vendor and the additional procedure, and you uncheck it, which means this is left blank. So then you see what happens. Ideally, in the scenario, system will not look into that relationship. It will directly create a PO for the additionals quantity, even though there is no relationship maintained for the vendor and the additionals procedure. Okay, so now let me remove all this stuff. Now I want to say that I don't want to generate the additionals just based on the purchase order, because there can be any changes. So only when I am receiving the goods physically, the system should trigger for the additionals. So sequence 1, movement type. I don't want to restrict for any site group of plan, a site group of DCs or stores. So irrespective of anything, it should happen. So I'm saying you generate the additionals purchase orders. Okay, this is an optional step. However, I will say like, okay, let me update my RIS, retail information system, as purchase order. Similarly, let me do it for 501, generate purchase order for additionals. It's enough. Let me save it. Let me create a PO for that material, MA21N. Ten pieces to my plant W001. So I have this PO 436. Okay, so let me try to create additional PO for this main PO. Against this purchase order, I'm getting this message: no documents for additionals exist. Okay, so let me do a goods receipt for that. So I had given this confirmation control as 003, which means I have to create an inbound delivery for that PO and do the goods receipt. So let me pass through this. So we could see that there is a material document created for that. I'll display the document. So there is a movement of this material with this movement type 101. Okay. So which is what we had configured in our additionals procedure. So let me go to the additionals monitor, WTAM 59. Let me not give this explicitly, even though the system has picked it up. One minute. So we execute it for this material document. And you could see that it is in the work list. You select that and generate a purchase order. Yes, another purchase order has been created. Okay, so this is how we generate the PO for additionals using the additionals monitor. We can still be able to, for example, like in real time, the business might want like, why I need to trigger this additionals monitor every time whenever I create a purchase order or a goods movement happens. So why it should not be done automatically? Okay, you can still be able to do that. Okay, for that you have to use this BAPI exit underscore ADDI underscore order underscore forms underscore 001 to retrieve the order data. Okay, so once this data is retrieved, then you can use this T code W2EOAC, or you can use this WTAOC. So once you do that, you will be able to, once you generate the data, once you generate the data from the BAPI exit underscore ADDI underscore order underscore forms underscore 01, then you will be able to use this transaction code WTAOC, or it is associated with this program ADDI underscore orders underscore create. You can use this program to generate the additionals automatically. So until then, you have to use this additionals monitor for generating the additionals PO. Hope you all found this additionals configuration useful. If you feel like there is something that could have been done the other way for better, kindly let me know so that I will do that and I will create another video for that. If you like this video, please share this with your friends, subscribe to my YouTube channel, and please disable ad blockers when you are visiting my blog www.maheshwaran.com. Till we catch up again with a new video, have a great day and have good practice.